Hello everyone, this is Navdha Soni, Assistant Professor, Department of Quality Assurance at LJ Institute of Pharmacy. Welcome to the online lecture series, initiative taken by LJ Institute of Pharmacy. In today's session, we will discuss about the non-aqueous titration. First of all, non-aqueous titration is the titration of substances dissolved in the solvents other than water. It is the most common titrimetric procedure used in the pharmacopeial assays and serve as double purpose. It is suitable for the titration of very weak acids and very weak bases, and it provides a solvent in which organic compounds are soluble. The most commonly used procedure is the titration of organic bases with perchloric acid in anhydrous acetic acid. This assay sometimes takes some perfecting in terms of being able to judge the endpoint precisely. Why non-aqueous titration is required? Oftentimes, we need to perform an acid-based titration in non-aqueous solvents due to the analyte is too weak acid or base to be titrated in water. Sometimes reactants or products are insoluble in water. Sometimes reactants or products react with water, and titration in water doesn't allow a sharp endpoint. But in the non-aqueous solvents with stronger base than OH-, it is possible to get a sharp endpoint. According to the Lauri-Bronsted and Lewis theory, when acid is reacted with water and it converts into the conjugate acid and conjugate base. It follows from this definition that an acid may be either an electrically neutral molecule, example HCl, or positively charged cation, example C6H5NH3+, or a negatively charged anion, example HSO4-. And a base may be either an electrically neutral molecule, example C6H5NH2, or anion, example Cl-. So, the substances which are potentially acidic can function as acids only in the presence of base to which they can donate a proton. Conversely, basic properties do not become apparent unless an acid is present. The apparent strength of an acid or base is determined by the extent of its reaction with the solvent. In aqueous solutions, all strong acids appear equally strong because they react with the solvent to undergo almost complete conversion to hydronium ion and the acid anion. In weakly protophenic solvents such as acetic acid, the extent of formation of the acetanium ion due to the addition of proton provides a more sensitive differentiation of the strength of acid and shows that the order of decreasing strength of acid in the perchloric, hydrobromic, sulfuric, hydrochloric and nitric. Acetic acid reacts incompletely with water to form hydronium ion and it's therefore a weak acid. In contrast, it dissolves in a base such as ethylene diamine and reacts so completely with the solvent that is, it behaves as a strong acid. This is called labeling effect. Labeling effect or solvent labeling. This labeling effect or solvent labeling refers to the effect of solvent on the properties of acids and bases. The strength of strong acid is limited or labeled by the basicity of the solvent. Similarly, the strength of strong base is labeled by the acidity of the solvent. When strong acid is dissolved in water, it reacts with it to form hydronium ion, that is H3O+. For an example, a strong acid HA is converted into H3O+ and A-. Any acid that is stronger than H3O+ will react with the water to form H3O+. Therefore, no acid stronger than H3O+ exists in the water. Similarly, when ammonia is the solvent, the strongest acid is ammonium. Thus, HCl and the super acid exert the same acidifying effect. The same argument applies to the bases. In water, OH- is the strongest base. Thus, even though sodium amide is an exceptional base, that is pKa of the NH3+, that is 33, in water, it is only as good as sodium hydroxide. On the other hand, NaNH2 is the far more basic reagent in ammonia than is NaOH. Solvent used in non-aqueous titration. Solvents which are used in the non-aqueous titration are called as non-aqueous solvents. There are following types like aprotic solvent, protogenic solvent, protophilic solvent and amphiprotic solvent. First, aprotic solvents. These are neutral, chemically inert substances such as benzene, chloroform. They have low dielectric constant, do not react with either acid or base, and therefore do not favor ionization. The fact that picric acid gives a colorless solution in benzene, which becomes yellow on adding aniline, shows that picric acid is not dissociated in benzene solution. And also, that is the presence of the base aniline, it functions as an acid. So the development of yellow color being due to the formation of the picrate ion. Carbon tetrachloride and toluene come in this group. They possess low dielectric constant and do not cause ionization in the solute. And it also do not undergo reaction with acid and base. These aprotic solvents are frequently used to dilute the reaction mixture. In case of protogenic solvents, they are acidic substances, example sulfuric acid. They exert a leveling effect on bases. Anhydrous acids such as hydrogen fluoride and sulfuric acid fall in this category. Because of their strength and ability to donate protons, they enhance the strength of weak bases. Example, sulfuric acid, formic acid, propionic acid, acetic anhydride, etc. They have high dielectric constant and ionized because of their strength and ability to donate protons. In the case of protophilic solvent, the protophilic solvents are the substance that possess high affinity for protons. The overall reaction can be represented as HB when react with S, it converted into the SH plus and B minus. So the equilibrium in this reversible reaction will be generally influenced by the nature of the acid and the solvent. Weak acids are normally used in the presence of strongly protophilic solvent, as their acidic strength are then enhanced and then become comparable to this of the strong acid. This is known as leveling effect. In the case of amphiprotic solvents, have both protophilic and protogenic properties. Examples are acetic acid and alcohol. They are dissociated to slight extent. The dissociation of acetic acid, which is frequently used as a solvent for titration of basic substances. For an example, acetic acid is converted into the H plus and CH3COO minus, that is acetic acid. Here the acetic acid is function as an acid. If very strong acid such as perchloric acid is dissolved in the acetic acid, the latter can function as base and combine with protons, which is donated by the perchloric acid, to form protonated acetic acid and onium ion. This HClO4, it converted into the H plus and ClO4 minus. Same like CH3COOH when react with the H plus ion, and it converted into the onium ion. Since the CH3COOH2, that is our onium ion, is readily donates its proton to base, and the solution of perchloric acid in glacial acetic acid function as strongly acidic solution. This glacial acetic acid is a solvent for base in the particular. The water content should be less than 1% and acetic anhydride is N. When weak base such as pyridine is dissolved in the acetic acid, this acetic acid exerts its leveling effect and enhances the basic property of the pyridine. It is possible, therefore, to titrate a solution of weak base in the acetic acid with perchloric acid in acetic acid and obtain a sharp endpoint. When attempts to carry out the titration in aqueous solution are unsuccessful. Other solvents like formic acid, which is only used for the titration of weakest base, example caffeine or urea. Trifluoroacetic acid, which is suitable as a solvent for weakest base, where acetic anhydride cannot be used because of the acetylation, but it is expensive solvent. Amphipotic basic solvent like ethylene diamine, butylamine, benzylamine, etc. And aprotic basic solvents like pyridine, dimethyl formamide and dimethyl sulfoxide. Most important is detection of the endpoint. The visual indicators are found to be most suitable for the detection of endpoint in this non-aqueous titration. The important indicators like crystal violet, auracet blue B, and quinidine red indicator, these are the various indicators for the non-aqueous titration. Crystal violet, it is used as a 0.5% solution in glacial acetic acid. It gives violet color in basic medium and yellowish green color in acidic medium. It is most widely used for the titration of pyridine with the perchloric acid. In the case of auracet blue B indicator, it is prepared 0.5% in glacial acetic acid and it gives blue color in basic medium while pink color in the acidic medium. In the case of quinidine red indicator, it is used 0.1% solution in methanol or ethanol. Methanol is more stable. It gives yellow color in basic medium while almost colorless in the acidic medium. Other indicators are also used like methyl red, naphthol benzene, thymol blue, which are already used in the non-aqueous titration. Next, that is titrants used in the non-aqueous titrimetry. Acidic titrants and basic titrants. In the case of acidic titrants, perchloric acid, p-toluene sulfonic acid, 2,4-dinitrobenzene sulfonic acid, these are the acidic titrants. In the case of basic titrants, tetrabutyl ammonium hydroxide, sodium acetate, potassium methoxide, sodium amino ethoxide, these are the basic titrants. Various assay is performed by non-aqueous titration. In the case of acidimetry in non-aqueous titration, it can be further subdivided into the two heads: titration of primary, secondary and tertiary amines and titration of halogen acid salts of base. Alkalimetry in non-aqueous titrations like titration of acidic substance. Advantages of non-aqueous titration like organic acids and base that are insoluble in wet hot water are soluble in non-aqueous solvents. Organic acid, which is of comparable strength to water, can be titrated easily in non-aqueous solvents. Bases also follow the same rules. The non-aqueous solvents may help to add more acid in the mixture. The individual acid can give separate endpoint in the different solvents. By the proper choice of solvents or indicators, the biological ingredients or the substances, whether acidic or basic, can be selectively titrated. In the case of non-aqueous titration, they are simple and accurate. Example of non-aqueous titrations are ephedrine preparation, codeine phosphate in the APC, tetracycline, terramycin, antihistamines, and various piperazine preparations. Thank you for watching this video. For more updates, please like, share, and subscribe our channel. Thank you once again.